Hello and welcome. We are really excited to have you here today for the OCI Multicloud Office Hours. This is a monthly event for EMEA. For those of you who may be new to our events, we are hosted on Cloud Customer Connect. I'm Lajos Sárecz, Business Development Manager in EMEA, and today we are joined by Thomas van Buggenhout, Principal Solution Architect at Oracle, to give you the introduction to Autonomous Database on Oracle Database at Azure. And on the panel today, we have OCI Multicloud experts Ijaz, Emil, Julian, and Mo to answer your questions. The office hour format will be a short presentation followed by Q&A for a total of 30 minutes. In this session, Thomas will first take us through the Autonomous Database on Oracle Database at Azure. Okay, that's enough for me. So go ahead and take it away, Thomas.
Thank you, Lajos. Thank you for the introduction. So today we are here to talk about the Autonomous Database for Oracle Database at Azure. But let us have a look at this slide first to talk about why we are doing this. When you look at the slide, you see that more than 98% of the companies who are moving to the cloud, they are using two clouds or more cloud environments in their business. And these are numbers that are coming from sources like S&P and Goldman Sachs. And we also know that most of the leaders in the different industries are very reliant on Oracle Exadata. So next to that, we also know that the 31 of the enterprise workloads are currently into the cloud. So there is a lot of opportunity to migrate to the clouds. And that's why we are bringing Oracle Exadata and Exadata technology to the cloud, as well as Autonomous Database. We know from the feedback we got from our customers that customers want choice, and customers do want the best of both worlds. They want to have that those functionalities we offer for in the Oracle Database, and like high availability and RAC, also the fully automated service of Autonomous Database, and the fast performance of the Exadata. But on the same time, they want to use their trusted applications in Azure. We talk about Azure Kubernetes Service, or they want to use Azure DevOps connecting to those databases. So this is why we started the partnership with Microsoft, and this is a partnership which already exists for quite some time. So we started this partnership and bringing the ability of the Oracle Database to Microsoft Azure using the Azure Interconnect, which is still available. And this will connect both clouds through a dedicated interconnect in a number of regions. And in 2 years ago, we extended that partnership by bringing Oracle Database Service for Azure, which is built on top of that interconnect technology. But last year, we even extended that partnership at a higher level by bringing our cloud and Microsoft Cloud to the same data center. So it's not only a move of the data plane closer to your application, but it's also a more seamless integration to use your services in and operate in one single cloud. So the current database at Azure offerings that we have today is the Exadata database service, which is actually the Exadata service which you might know on-prem, but we're bringing it to the cloud. And we already have this offering in OCI, of course, for a long time, but since a few months now, we also have that service available directly and operated within the Azure cloud. So ExaData database service, it's a dedicated infrastructure for the customer. It's a high level of isolation, and as it mentioned, dedicated infrastructure means that this infrastructure is specifically located for one customer. You get full control of the database, and you get and the control plane, and you still have access to the guest OS. But on top of that ExaData database service, we have also built Autonomous Database. Autonomous Database is already available in OCI for years. And recently, we also made this available to run on and integrate with Azure, within the Azure cloud. It's a fully managed database, right? The provisioning, the patching, the upgrades, the tuning, maintenance, and hardware refreshes, all are happening on an, in an automated way. And it also offers a very elastic way of deploying, meaning that the resources that you can apply to the autonomous database, like the storage or compute, are elastic. You can scale your compute, and you can scale your storage resources for what you need, and you will all only be paid for what you use. And of course, the autonomous database offers low code tools like Apex, ELT, AI, and Graph. Well, autonomous database is actually more than a database service itself, right? It's more like a platform as a service. It offers so much more than only the database. We also offer things like REST services, which allows you to build your own APIs. We also offer a wide range of tools for machine learning, for data integration. Actually, for all purposes, we offer tools, and we offer them for free on top of the autonomous database. So it's a very interesting offering that we bring here and we bring to Microsoft. How do we operate, right? It starts with, of course, by purchasing the offer, right? Currently, how you do this is there is a conversation with the Oracle sales team, which will place then a private offer in the marketplace, and that private offer is something that you then accept in Azure, and you also purchase it so that you can start running the service while the metering and the billing is done for your existing Mac credits. Once you have started that, and we will show that in a demo a little bit later, you can start creating the ExaData and also now the autonomous database. And then after that, you can combine that with the Azure services of choice. The application services, but also logging and metrics are available and fully integrated within Azure. So let's see the next one. So we'll show a small demo to see how, once you have purchased this offering, on how we can operate this in Azure. So what we will do is we deploy a new autonomous database in the portal, and you will also see that it's more than not in the demo, but you have to know that this is more than a database. It will also offer graph, JSON, and integrate with services in Azure, like integration with Entra IDE. So for the deployment of the autonomous database, we will go to the Azure portal. So in the Azure portal, you will find the Oracle database at Azure. And once we go to the Oracle database at Azure, you will be able to create that Oracle autonomous database. We give the database a name, and then after that, we will choose the configuration. During the configuration, you will choose which type of workload you are using, transaction processing or data warehouse, and you can scale the compute resources as well as the storage services from the start. You can also enable auto-scaling for both compute and storage services. Then there's the backup retention, which you can set up to 60 days. And after that, we will create the database with the database with the administrators. Once all of these things are entered, you can review and create, and you can start creating the service. So once this service is created, it will take a few minutes. This is the video is a little bit faster, so it will show you after a few seconds which is created. And then let's go back. There is a link into OCI, and this is an important link because most of the functionality is available already on the Azure portal. But for a few of the functionalities which are not available yet on the Azure portal, you can use this link, which will take you directly into the OCI console. And in the OCI console, it will take you directly to the specific service within OCI. And there you have the additional functionality, which can be managed from there. So first of all, as you can see, this is the overview page. As you can see, this is the overview page. The overview page will show you the exact same overview as you would see on the Azure portal, but it does give you some additional possibilities. You can manage resources from this side, but you can also manage database connections. You can manage resources and enable auto scaling. There's also something which we call database actions, where you have a set of development tools, where you have a set of administrative tools. Also, Data Studio and monitoring is available from those database actions. As you can see, all of this is available from the Azure portal, from the OCI console, but most of these will also be made available through the Azure portal very soon. And this concludes the demo video of the portion, and it concludes our presentation. Lajos?
Yeah, thank you, Tomas. Do we provide migration tools to migrate the on-premise databases to database at Azure, especially if that is autonomous database?
So as you might know, the migration to an autonomous database is a logical migration, and different tools are available for this. There is, of course, Data Pump, Golden Gate, but to orchestrate that migration and to make that smoother migration from on-premise to ADB in Azure, you can use a tool called ZDM or Zero Downtime Migration. It's actually an orchestrator which helps you do either a logical offline or a logical online migration to Oracle Database at Azure Autonomous Database.
Just related to the migration, we also have a tool called Golden Gate, right? Mm-hmm. So that is also an option, right, for cross-platform migration either, right?
Exactly. So the Golden Gate migration can be used for ADB, for the logical migration, but it can also be used for cross-platform migration if you would choose to go to ExaData. It can be used for cross-version. So if you have an older database version running still and you want to migrate this to an ExaData to the latest version, Golden Gate also and ZDM offers that possibility to do that migration. So it's part of the tool set that ZDM can use. So Golden Gate is one of the tools that can be used specifically for that migration.
I see. Thanks a lot for your explanation. Okay, so since there are still no more questions or not no questions on the Q&A, I think I will conclude and wrap up. So yeah, we greatly appreciate all your time who attended this session, and special thanks to you, Thomas, also Ijaz, Emil, Julian, and Mo for these office hours. And if you have any questions afterwards, please feel free to join us on the Multicloud forum and continue the discussion there. And we hope to see you next time. Have a nice day. Bye-bye.